There's a token out there that has been going since December, up, 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 with basically no major dips down. I'm going to tell you about it right now. It relates very strongly to the Jupiter ecosystem, and I'll explain why it keeps on going up. As usual, though, let's start at jupe.ag and let's come up to perps and click on perps. We've already done some videos on perps, but what we're interested in is earn. So in the middle, click on earn. Now you can see this is an APY for the JLP pool. APY is annual percentage yield, meaning the yield that's compounded. It's 74%. It can go higher or lower depending on a few things. Then we've got here the Jupiter Liquidity Provider Pool. So the JLP token is a token I'm referring to, and this is essentially an index fund of Solana, Ethereum, Wrapped BTC, USDC, and USDT. But in addition to this, you're also getting traders' profit and loss and 75% of the generated fees. So whatever it costs to open a position, close a position, borrowing fees, etc. Now I'm going to show you, before we go and have a look too much further, at what the price has done. So let's go to coingecko.com, come up to the top right, and let's type in JLP. Here it is here. Click on this. It's up 0.15% or 0.1% in the last 24 hours. You can see it goes up a little, down a little, up a little, but that's not really what we're interested in. What we want to see is max. If we zoom out maximum, you can see since this was launched last year, November 23rd, this has gone up and up and up. And although there have been small times when there's been a bit of a crash down the price, as an example, if there's a flash crash in the markets, basically overall, it's just gone higher and higher. So we'll come back here to JLP pool and let's have a look at it. So the total value locked is this, $563.7 million. And the assets under management limit, 600 million. They can always increase this cap, but then we've got this pool size here. So there's a current weightage for Sol of 44%. That's what they're aiming for. Sometimes it's a little bit higher, sometimes it's a little bit lower. And there's a utilization rate, which we don't really need to cover, but basically depends on the traders. If they're trading long or if they're shorting, then these will all change. There's also a decent amount of USDC and USDT at 35% of the entire liquidity pool. There's also some ETH and some wrapped BTC. Now, of course, not financial advice, but it is expected during a bull run, prices will rise. So wrapped BTC, we're probably going to expect that to go higher, ETH to go higher, and I personally think SOL will go higher. Of course, not financial advice. So when you've got a little bit of these tokens, as well as some USDC, and then in addition to that, you're also capturing generated fees, 75% of all the fees go into this pool, you have a potentially lucrative token. And because it's a liquidity provider token and essentially an index token, you also have minimized risk. So if SOL went down significantly, but BTC went slightly up and ETH went slightly up and these two stayed the same, then you could assume that the token price wouldn't actually drop too much. Whereas if you just held all SOL, it could go up a lot, you'd make a lot, or it could go down a lot, you'd lose a lot. So how do you get JLP? And then what do you do in order to earn the yield? It's very, very simple. You just go back to trade, connect your wallet, of course. We'll go with Solflare today. We've got a little bit of USDC. You just literally type in JLP. I've already got some here, but let's go and buy some more. We'll buy like $200 worth or whatever you want. Swap it and approve the transaction. And that's all you need to do. Now, you don't have to do anything with the JLP token in order to actually capture those fees. Those fees are already generated, and it just accrues back to the token's price. Similar to how JupeSol does with their LST JupiterSol. So here we've currently got 61 JLP. We know we're earning at present a decent APY. It can go higher or lower. And essentially we have an index fund of these assets with also generated fees. Now I'm not sure how much the Jupiter Perps exchange has actually generated in fees, but it's a lot. We can see here at Dune.com, we can see quite often it's over $1 million. Sometimes it's around $500,000. And then on other occasions, it's over $2 million. Either way, since it's been running, it's generated over $100 million worth in fees. And as we can see from this tweet, sometimes there's over $1 billion worth of Jupiter perps being put on in 24 hours. So that's a JLP token, and you may want to add it to your portfolio.